Today's episode of the DJ Blaze Radio Show podcast is brought to you by Unfiltered. They have long sleeve tees, hoodies, joggers, leggings, masks, and so much more. Visit them at unfilteredforever.com and use the promo code Blaze, B-L-A-Z-E, and get 10% off on your order. Remember, there's a science to being you. Let's start the show.
Let's get it started in here.
Gossip, music, news, entertainment, and heated discussions. The DJ Blaze Radio Show starts now.
Nothing is something, we made it out of it. Mink, drag the floor, tell Peter, peep the exoticness. I see you rappers, energy funny, that's politics. I love them all, bitches wall to wall like a hieroglyph. Summer bodies take off spring, I tell her swallow it, game. Don't be a lost flame, come live out your dreams. Used to sleep on floors, now we riding ghosts. Ouija board, cherry oak, sweet decor. Boy, your life is CB4, clean. Kiss rain, big bling since 16. Sweet, think it's a game, so your shit gets split screen. Can I dream? A fly cars, hoes with 2 degrees. Just know when you the king, jealous eyes float the scene. Vintage peacoat, nigga flowing like he could have been the king of each coast. I'm the Cardinino. If I'm ever in the jam, best believe I squeeze toast. All black whip, bitch, you best believe that he was. This is hell.
Yeah. What up, world? It's your boy Be Easy.
And I'm Courtney.
And we back for another episode of the DJ Blaze Radio Show podcast. You know, you can find us Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, all of that stuff. And we got a guest back in the building. My man BC Bud.
Yo.
Welcome back, my brother.
Appreciate it. Glad to be here.
Yeah. Thank you for sliding through on this good weekend. Had a couple people hit me up on your last time. They was like, yeah, who was that guy? He got a radio show? I'm like, yeah, he got something. It's coming. So
coming soon.
Yeah. You keep coming. You pause. You might be a fan favorite.
Appreciate it, man. Hopefully. Let's get it happening.
Yeah. I hope you can make somebody laugh. God damn it. Courtney.
Sir.
How many plants you bought this week?
Ooh, two. Well, wait. One. I bought one plant this week.
Did one of them happen to be a chrysanthemum?
Nope. That's a flower. I tell you that every week.
And I'm ass every week. What about a ficus? What is that?
No, actually that is a plant. I already have a ficus. I didn't buy a ficus this week.
Courtney, you can never have too many ficuses. Fici? What's the plural of ficus? Ficuses.
I think they just still say ficus.
Ficus. Kind of like deer.
And like cactus. Cacti.
What kind of plant? Bad. What kind of plant nigga is you?
Shut the fuck up. They do say cacti. Shut up.
Yeah. How I know more about plants than you about cacti?
You know about plurals. You don't know about plants.
Shit. Give me a plant quiz right now, goddammit.
What's the botanical name for a snake plant?
Slytherin.
That is a lie.
My bad. I'm in my Harry Potter bag. My bad. Excuse me, beloved. So your week was okay. You bought two plants and hold up. How you a plant mama and you smoke plants? That's not cannibalism.
That makes me even more of a plant mama, baby.
It sound like you a cannibal.
Most of the plant mamas I know smoke a little something.
Heathens. You don't see me raising chickens, do it. Falling in love with chicken little and shit. Hell no. Nigga, I'ma cook the hell out of that chicken. Where's George? I done killed Chicken George. He's marinating in juices and spices, Lord. He's going on the glory. He's going on the chicken heaven. I'm sending chickens to heaven, Lord. If there's heaven for animals, it's a whole bunch of chickens in animal heaven.
And cows.
Oh, yes. Oh, and pigs, too.
And like,
yeah, ooh, it's a lot of pigs up there. A
lot of pigs in heaven's animal farm.
Yeah.
Y'all remember last week I was talking about Judy Blume?
Mm-hmm.
And I was listening to The Breakfast Club, And I was hating because Judy Blume sent Charlamagne an autographed book of one of her books. It was called, what is it? Hello There. Something, It's Me, Margaret. Hello God, It's Me, Margaret.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember that book. And she sent him a, but they ain't got shit on Super Fudge, though. But anyway. So, shout out to you and your week buying plants and burning plants and inhaling the smoke that you burn from the plant. BC, Bud, how was your week?
Yep.
How was your week? How was your time away from here since your last visit?
Good week. Feels like it's been about 1 million years since I've been here, so I'm just maintaining, you know what I mean, trying to be better.
Was that shade? Was that shade?
Nah, not even. Oh, okay. Not even. Just, you know, it just feels like a long time since November, 2 months ago.
Oh, it's been only 2 months.
Yeah,
oh, well, we'll call you back then. You ain't even gone long enough to appreciate.
Nah, everything good, though, man. Just being better, health getting better every day. You know what I mean? Had a COVID scare back over the summer. And
oh, Lord.
Recovering everything. Gucci, yeah.
Word. Did COVID, do you have any lasting effects of the COVID?
I did. So I actually had COVID last summer, but it messed me up. I was in the hospital for almost, 8 days, ICU for 6.
Damn. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it almost took your boy out, man. But
did they put you on a ventilator?
Nah, I was on breathing assistance with the oxygen, but not with the ventilator.
Oh, you had the nose thing.
Yeah, it had it. Well, they had gave me the whole head apparatus, like over the nose and mouth.
Damn.
Yeah, it was bad off, bro. But like I said, health getting better every day, man. Since it was still bad in November, but like starting to feel better now and getting strength back and everything. So
What? I did notice a little wheezing when you was on the show last time.
That might have not been that, you know what I mean?
Oh, okay. All right. Well, shout out to that, too. Well, I did see an article that said they was trying to see if marijuana could lessen the effects of COVID. So, you know, you could be in research.
Listen, be patient number one, you know what I mean?
Word.
And let's say that just helped with all the quick recovery.
Word. Well, you guys, you know, we have segments, and our first segment is our feel good moment of the week. Courtney.
Yes.
What's your feel good moment of the week?
My feel good moment of the week was being able to put out my first giveaway on my plant page.
Shout out to
and
that.
To have two black women owned small businesses contribute to my giveaway.
Shout them out.
No pressure. No Pressure Co. by Pamela Renee.
Who's been on the show, friend of the show, who's been on the show before.
Yeah. That's my girl. And Tanisha from Bay the Plant Bay. She's out in California and she makes custom planters. And she's really dope with some paint and a planter. So
planters like peanuts?
Planters.
Not joking. Don't follow me up, child.
I'm finna say, come on now. I know you know.
Yeah, I act stupid. I ain't
maybe doing. I should call it a pot.
Plant. We know. But the planters are like the small pots, though, ain't it?
No, a planter can be any size.
Oh, okay. All right. I thought it was some small shit. So shout out to, what's your plant page?
Peace, Love, Plants with 2 S's.
Okay. And you gave away. And why did you do a giveaway?
Because I hit 1,000 followers. I'm a little over that now, but I had to wait for all of the stuff to get in. And I also purchased a humidifier myself, I have a few of these humidifiers around my house to contribute to the plant giveaway as well.
Oh, so you gave that away too?
Yep. So a tote from No Pressure Co., a pouch from Bay Plant Bay, and a planter from Bay the Plant Bay, and then a humidifier.
From Peace, Love, Plants. Wow. You could have said it was from the DJ Blaze Radio Show podcast, but maybe I'll donate next time so that we can get our name on there. Because I guess to get 1,000 followers in a, because you had your plant page for how long?
Since June 23rd.
Oh, 6 months? And you already had 1,000 followers.
I hit 1,000 the first week of January.
I'm a do like you and take some butt naked plant pictures.
Oh my God.
I'm gonna have like naked ones.
17 cacti. And I'll be peeking. I'm gonna be peeking around the thistles of the cacti.
You make me real sick.
I know I do. So, Cliff, how was your week? And what's your feel good moment of the week?
Helping a single mom of five actually getting into college, man.
Getting into college?
Yeah.
I'm going to let you finish.
She wanted to finish her degree, but wasn't sure if she could or not. She came, hollered at me at the J.O., sat down, talked with her, and we were able to help her get into college, man. She'll start evening classes this week, man. So, yeah.
Shout out to her, for one. But, Lord, five of them things?
Five of them, bro.
Damn. You got an age range?
I just know the oldest two, she said, were in middle school, and the other ones were in elementary. So they're very spread out.
That ain't too spread, middle and elementary.
That is not spread. That sounds like a little bit of dose steps to me.
Yeah, that's the only thing that ain't spread.
And ain't no twins either, because I did ask. When she said, yeah, you know, I'm not sure if I'll be able to do this because I got five kids. I was like, oh, well, you know, you can get a babysitter or two. You know what I mean? So
spread the wealth. Now, what kind of van did she drive up there in? Because she ain't got no kind of car. Five damn kids.
Got to have a minivan or something with two doors on both sides.
Yeah.
I didn't even see what she got out of, bro.
Shout out to her, though. You know, she had a whole bunch of kids, and now she want to make her life better by going to school at night. So shout out to that young lady. My feel-good moment of the week, it's with helping people also. Now, you know, I've been talking about a network and all. I've been alluding to the fact of a network. But me and two of the members of the Relationship Status Podcast, we started a podcast network, and we've been working with people basically all year during COVID, trying to, you know, get people started and stuff. And we have a couple podcasts that already were established or whatever. But the first podcast that, you know what I'm saying, we got it out the mud with them. You know what I'm saying? They dropped their first three episodes Wednesday or Thursday, the Perfect People podcast. And we dropped that, so I was excited about that. And seeing how they were excited about it too was my feel-good moment. Like, yeah, because when I first started doing podcasting, it was just like it was up. I don't even know if I listened to the first one when it first came out or whatever. That was back when you had to have an iPod to listen to podcasts. But, you know, to have them put their podcasts out or whatever, I thought it was good. And if you listening and you need a podcast, you can holler at me.
Message.
But it's going to cost you. Ain't shit free. But anyway, yeah, shout out to them, the Perfect People Podcast. Y'all can check them out everywhere you get your podcasts. And we got some more podcasts too. We got coming, Mr. BC Bud. He gonna do a podcast. It's coming up soon. Yeah. He's gonna be on sports, right?
Yes, sir.
Yep. And then Courtney, she gonna do her own podcast coming soon. That I'm putting it out there.
Yep.
And it's gonna be talking about topsoil.
That is not the only thing we're going to talk about. You make me so sick.
Man, that sounds real rich, bro.
Yeah, real rich. Topsoil and tilling. Tilling. It's going to be a lot of tilling is going to be going on her podcast.
You make me so sick, bro.
Hoe talks. It's going to be about hoeing.
We're going to talk a little bit about hoeing.
But it's going to be digging up the dirt. H-O-E-I-N-G. That hoeing. Then planting the seeds of real seeds, not planting the seeds of my in your mind and none of that shit. Just be talking about plants all day. I'm just joking,
that is,
but yeah.
Ryan's gonna say that is not the case.
But yeah, Courtney gonna start her own podcast too. So we look forward to all of that. But yeah, that's my feel good moment of the week. I guess we'll get into all of these stories, y'all. One feel good moment for the nation of hip hop. Hip hop should be its own nation. One nation, and it'll be under the groove. We'll be getting down for the funk of it. Now, let me stop. Anyway, Dr. Dre, he's reportedly been released from the hospital. You know, the last couple weeks he's been in for a brain aneurysm. I think he's been in for 2 weeks now, right? Mm-hmm. He went in 2 weeks ago. Yeah, because he went in when we did our last Power episode. Ice-T confirmed on social media that Dre finally left the hospital and he's home recuperating. So shout out to Dr. Dre. I don't know what's like. Do you get headaches after you get an aneurysm or?
I have no. Anybody that I've ever known or heard of that has had an aneurysm went on to glory. Yeah. So I have no idea. Or they came out of it and was more like in a vegetable state.
What?
Mm-hmm. So I don't really.
Plants.
I'm not.
Oh, my bad. Sorry. That was bad. Go ahead. You're not what?
I'm not real sure, like, what is even anything.
You know you could have laughed at that.
No, instead I chose to roll my eyes, okay?
Like you said, they in that by and by are the ones that I knew that had aneurysms.
I can't even imagine, like, how somebody recovered. Bro, if I get a headache, I ain't the same for days afterwards, bro. So, like, a whole bursted vessel, man, like, shout out to him on the recovery, man. And we wish him the best.
Yeah. See, that would happen when you poor and you have an aneurysm. You just die. You don't really got to live for you. Your brain just, I don't want to work no more. His brain was like, nigga, we got to spend these billies. Yeah, that's all that was.
Spend these billies.
And I think he wanted to stay around so he can make his wife, his ex-wife suffer a little bit more so she won't get all his money.
I mean, that ain't a horrible reason.
Yeah. Let's see what else happened this week. I did see something about the rapper wife and Lucci. Y'all hear about this? Mm-mm. He was wanted for murder.
Oh wow!
Yeah, multiple charges, including felony murder, aggravated assault, participation in criminal street gang activity. In possession of a firearm during the commission of a felony. It happened in December in Southwest Atlanta. Some people call it the SWATs. Left one man dead from a gunshot wound to the head. That, you get shot in the head, they meant to kill you.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere else, it might, you know, you can muddle the lines like, yeah, I just sent a message, but yeah, they meant to kill this dude. They say a second victim was shot only minutes after the first. Said they already made two arrests, 23-year-old Ravon Boyd and 17-year-old Leroy Pitts. I'm just here to say
young.
Yeah, and these was whole niggas. Ravon, R-A-apostrophe. Is that apostrophe? Yeah, V-O-N. Boyd and Pitts. Pitts, I don't know, but Leroy, you 17 years old and your name Leroy. Your dad is 72. Damn. Boy, I don't know no white boys. Y'all know any white boys? B-O-Y-D?
Not one.
I don't know. No. Not a one.
Not a one.
Let me tell you how black Boyd is in my community. Nigga last name Boyd, he cut hair. That's anyway. These were two colored fellas. They got booked for murder. They must be snitched on YFN and Lucci.
And see, my question is, like, if you I know he may not be like on T.I. and Jay-Z money yet, but if you making rapper money, bro, why are you even still associating to that level, bro? Like, at a certain point, you got to have goons and somebody else who can, like, do that stuff for you, bro. You shouldn't put your hands on it, though, man.
Yeah. You
mean, like, people shouldn't have even known that it came from him.
Exactly.
I agree with that.
Yeah. Maybe he wasn't there. Maybe they just told, like, he told him to do it, like you said, because there was a 911 call and the girl was like, somebody just got thrown out of their car or whatever, and they walked up to him and he was shot in the face. Then another guy, they threw another guy out. He got thrown out the car at a fire department, but that guy lived. I don't want to, you know, tell people how to commit crimes, but I mean, hopefully he would have done it like that. But either way, even if he did, these other two people got caught and he going to jail. Since then, he's turned himself in. Matter of fact, he was supposed to be here this weekend.
Oh, word.
I think it was weekend. Yeah, he was supposed to do a party here this weekend. People still partying during COVID. But anyway.
I seen Boots supposed to be coming there.
Yeah, so. And Boosie just got shot not too long ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, YFN Lucci, if you didn't know, he was, he's dated. I don't know if they're still together, though.
They got back together.
They did get back together. You know who I'm talking about?
Regine Carter.
Carter. And you know who her daddy is? Lil Wayne. Who also is in trouble with guns. Mm-hmm. He got caught on a plane with a gun. But anyway, during one of her recent episodes, Wendy Williams, she gave some advice to Regine. Said she needed to make a clean break from this relationship following his legal trouble. She said, we all around here, including the men here, we're like, who is she to tell us how to conduct ourselves? She's only 21 years old. Like, we don't want to hear advice from a 21-year-old privileged, and you are privileged. You know that. Beautiful, enhanced. The whole world is yours. Who are you to tell us about relationships? I'm going through a divorce. I'm going to call Regine. She continued, adding, hopefully you're not going to get back with him. First of all, it's wrong because he has 4 kids. And I know your dad, Lil Wayne, did a song with him. So what? Your dad's in trouble himself. I just said that. I know. But yeah, that was her advice. She needed him to get away. Y'all like my Wendy Williams impression, I know.
Regine did not listen because she literally just posted, Ray's doing well, guys, and he's in good spirits, and he'll be home soon.
Yeah, he probably will, hopefully.
When I saw that, I just rolled my eyes because I agree with Wendy. She should go for a clean break.
No, stay with him.
Oh my
Do
God.
That bid with that nigga. Who the hell is Wendy Williams to talk?
Listen, Wendy ain't no damn body to talk, but I do agree that Regine need to take a clean break and get the fuck on.
2 reasons I'm not taking relationship advice from Wendy Williams. 1, like she said, she going through a divorce, but her husband had a whole nother family. Like, he said the girl, like, and the woman he had, she wasn't even, like, you know, working on her own and shit. She was basically a housewife off of Wendy Williams' money. Had a house, a car. I think she took all that shit back, though, didn't she? Maybe I could sure shut the fuck up. But she does cocaine. Anyway. She do so much.
Slide that on in there.
Yeah, she do so much cocaine, she fall out at work talking about she got
overheated.
Yeah, she overheated.
Yeah, so that blood vessel's been overheated from all that.
I don't care that it came from Wendy. That would have been my thoughts regardless. Mm. Regine need a clean break, period.
She's just stunting like a damn daddy.
Oh, yeah, go.
Right. Yeah, stunting like a damn daddy. Trying to get it down here. It ain't 500 degrees.
Oh, my God. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you want to know why old boy got locked up, though? Because the damn block is hot? Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep. I'm trying to think of another Lil Wayne song. I can't think of none. I need a list. I should have pulled up a list. Mm-hmm. Anyway, y'all, speaking of hip-hop, Cardi B, she's going to be in a starring role, y'all. Did y'all hear about this? Yeah, she landed her very first leading movie role in an upcoming comedy. I know she was in, what's that? Oh, yeah, Hustlers with Jennifer Lopez. I think she did okay in that.
Yeah.
Yeah, she played a stripper.
I mean, I feel like she did okay because, you know, she was a stripper.
From life
so it was
experiences.
Just like, right. It was easy to be in there like you talking to the girls that you used to be talking to when you was doing that.
Yeah, she's going to be in a comedy called Assisted Living. I guess she's going to be an LPN? CNA. One of them. You know, she they favorite rapper. Say it's described as a raucous comedy with tremendous heart in the vein of classic funny films like Sister Act and Miss Doubtfire. I don't, what? Cardi B and Sister Act and Miss Doubtfire, I don't see. Say it follows Cardi B as the character Amber, a small-time crook who finds herself in over her head when a heist goes wrong.
So she's like starring.
Yeah, yeah, it's her junk. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, it says Amber disguises herself as an elderly woman and hides out in the one place no one will look, her estranged grandmother's nursing home.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, is this something that's coming straight to like Netflix, or is it going like supposed to be in the movies when they open up or what?
Let me see what it says. It's coming out early this year. Oh, it says to the big screen. But it's probably going to be like some kind of HBO Max type shit.
Okay.
Where you can go to the movies or you can stream it, because niggas, I don't know why niggas want to sit in the damn movies.
Bro, dead. And listen, I'm a movie head, bro. Like before the pandemic, I had the unlimited movie subscription and everything. I was in there 2-4 times a week checking out movies that I wouldn't even normally watch, but because I had the unlimited subscription, I was like, I'm gonna pull up. But ain't no way, bro. Like,
nah.
Dead.
Motherfuckers don't, like, I was in Arby's yesterday and two people they didn't have masks on, and I made it clear, abundantly clear, that I did not want them anywhere near me. Every time they get close, I take two steps and look at them funny with my mask on and stuff. Like, and they say in the movies, like, you have to wear your mask inside at certain movies that's open, but you can take your mask off to eat. Like, that don't make no sense. That don't make no sense. Like, I just have my mask off all the time, just saying I'm eating. But
yeah, the movies ain't a thing for me. Not that they're open here in New York anyway, but when they were talking about opening them briefly, Brittany and I was easy like, it's a dub. I know, but we have a drive-in movie theater, so when summer comes, we'd be more inclined to do that. They don't get every single like new movie, but we'd be more inclined to do that. But I'm not going in nobody's theater.
Yeah, they had the movie. Oh, go
the
ahead,
movies please. Wasn't even the closest, like the cleanest place before the pandemic, bro. Yeah. Like,
right.
Let alone afterwards. That's, yeah, it's a hard no.
Yeah, yeah. Unless you get some of them movies, though, they have the assigned seats and the seats recline and shit.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing like telling a motherfucker to get up out your seat. Oh, man.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I did used to appreciate that.
Yeah.
You in the wrong seat.
That take you back to Kings of Comedy with Cedric the Entertainer. I wish a motherfucker will be in my damn seat. I done paid $22 per ticket for these motherfucking seats.
I'd be the same way when we used to go to concerts too. Like, excuse you, no. Well, I just wanted to sit. I don't give a goddamn way. You just wanted to see it.
It says A7. This say A7 right here. You up there?
Period.
They try to show you your ticket like this. No, mine say A7 right here.
Listen, yeah, that's what you got to do. You got to give them the head dog. You look down at your ticket. Look at the seat. Look at the ticket, and then look them in the eye like, yeah, you needs to be moving.
Right. So what you gonna do?
Yeah. I had to do that. Went to a comedy show. I had to do that one time too. Yeah. That's something I'm looking, I want to come back. Movies. I do miss going to the movies, going to concerts.
Yeah.
And shows.
I miss concerts and comedy shows. I thought I would miss the movies more than what I actually do. And I only think that's because I wasn't even going to the movies as often before. You remember I told you, especially like with more like black trauma movies, I would just like buy the ticket and not go see, like support, but I'm not watching that. So I feel like leading up to this, like Queen and Slim, I think it was, and like a whole bunch of movies that came out around that, like I was just buying the ticket and not going because I just.
Funny that you mentioned that. That was the last movie I went to see in the movies.
The last one I saw, I'm sure, was Endgame.
That was after. That was before Queen and Slim came out, right?
That, I thought it was after Queen and Slim.
Queen and Slim came out in 2019, if I'm mistaken, like November 2019.
And Endgame, no, I think it was, let me look, because yeah, white man's, you got to think. I am, because Avengers Endgame came out 2019.
April 26, 2019 was Endgame.
Right.
Yeah.
And so that's what I went. And then Queen and Slim
came out in like October or November. Might be December.
Oh, it was November. So yeah, so Endgame. Avengers Endgame was the last movie that I've seen in theaters. And that is right, because early 2020, when I went to Texas to see my sister, she was trying to get me. She was like, please watch it. Please watch it with me. Let's cry and all this. And I just.
Oh, Queen and Slim?
Yeah, and I just was not interested.
That's one of the movies where I can't watch again.
So, and you, I felt like it was going to be that for me. A lot of people joke about Precious, but I watched Precious one time in theaters, and I vowed to never watch that again.
I saw it one time, and then I read the book.
Yeah.
Nigga, that book is crazy. It way worse than the damn
The movie. Book is way worse. I did not finish the book.
Yeah, that book is disgusting.
I did not finish the book at all. For Colored Girls is another one of those that was one and done and Thou Art Loose. It only take one time. I don't need that. I don't want to feel heavy like that. I go to the movies for fun. I don't go to leave crying and sad. And The Hate U Give was a really good book that translated well on screen, but it only took me one time.
That's the one with the little girl and she see a shooting or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
It was good. It was really good. And the book was even good. I didn't cry in the book. Like, my feelings translated to anger when I was reading the book. But seeing it on screen, it translated to like the anger that made me cry. And I was like, okay, this was really good. I would buy this to like have it in my collection or so, I guess, for the support of it all, but I'm not watching it again. Same thing I did with Precious and the rest of them. I have them to support. But I will never turn them on again.
What about you, Cliff? Is there a movie that you can't go see again?
Nah, I'm a movie head. Like I kind of, I enjoy it. Now I will say, she mentioned For Colored Girls. Like I watched that one time through with the eyebrows up the whole time. And then when a little light bright with the eyes, threw them babies out the window, I was like, yeah, nah, bro, I'm good on this right here.
Yeah. I was like, what? He threw multiple babies out the window, right?
Yeah. Yep,
it was two of them.
Yeah, that was a Tyler Perry joint, ain't it?
Yeah.
I think it was, yeah.
He was wilding on that one, bro, for real.
He wild the fuck out. From the whole backwoods ass abortion, I was like, yeah, nah, this is a dub for me.
I can't watch, I only watched Get Out one time. That's a movie I can't watch that again.
I agree. That's all it took. That's all it took. Didn't see the other one though. And I kind of want to, but people were saying that it wasn't really, that wasn't why I didn't watch, but I still, that one is still on my list. What was the other Jordan Peele one he did?
Us.
Yes. I didn't watch that. And I didn't watch it because I thought it was horror. Y'all know I'd be a scaredy cat and I don't want to watch no horror films.
Oh yeah. That shit. It's I ain't gonna say it's horror. It's more like a slasher, suspense type feel.
Yeah.
If Brandon can take it, I feel like I can take it because Brandon don't be with that horror shit either.
Yeah, I don't do horror. Nah, I was watching it. All the lights on. I had my pistol.
I'm gonna watch it with the lights on too. In the daytime, blinds open. I want all the light up in here.
For me, that's part of the reason that I liked going to the movie theaters, though, is for the experience, like with the surround. Like, I got a little big screen TV here to the cradle, 65-inch and surround sound, but ain't nothing like that darkened theater with that huge screen, that rumbling sound and stuff. Like, we talking earlier about the last movies we went to. I went and saw Bad Boys for Life. I think that was the last one I saw in the theaters, and I enjoyed it. And so I was like, yo, I'm gonna watch it here to the crib, and it still wasn't the same, man.
Go ahead, my bad.
I was going to say the sound for me is the part that takes me out. Because I realized one time, I think it was when Texas Chainsaw Massacre was out and I was still in high school, went to movies with my friends. And I was literally like folded in a chair with my hands covering my ears. And my friend was like, all right, Courtney, you're being ridiculous. So I was like, okay, I'm going to keep my ears covered, but I'm going to watch. And I was able to sit through the movie and it was okay. And I was like, it's the sound. It's too freaking much. Fast forward to being at home. We have the whatever that was you just called it. Anyway, it's behind our sectional, but it's behind the one that I particularly sit in. Mm. So when we're watching something and she, the subwoofer. And so we're watching something and Brittany got that shit up, I just be like, hold on. This feeling a little too much. Like we need to switch spots or we got to turn it down. Because even a suspenseful movie with all that subwoofering going on can turn real scary to me. Okay.
And they're good at that shit. You be watching it and shit. And
hell yeah.
cat walk past real fast, you be like, and you jump and shit. Yeah, I don't want that shit, bro.
And that's why I be telling Brittany, and she just be like, and she don't like horror movies either, but every now and then she get in this little whatever she be in, and she be wanting that subwoofer to be woofering, and she want to be, girl, listen, I'm asleep on top of your motherfucking head tonight. We got to turn the lights off, turn the lights on. We got to do something. I ain't going to be up in here, because I get in the bed real quick, be like, Brittany, you heard that? And then she ready to be like, Quentin, I ain't doing this shit with you tonight. Mm-hmm. Like, we got to pick one. Turn the subwoofer down.
And y'all got a lot of room for like a killer or something to hide in y'all house.
We do. All these doors. I just be like, Brittany, I'm so scared. Brittany, don't say that. And then, oh no, guys, because I was on Amazon this week looking up the stuff, because our front door and our back door has like opening at the top. So and I was like, through. I need to find like a tent or something to fill in these little things, because I have reefs on both, but I be feel like motherfucker can peek through the reefs and stuff.
They do be peeking though.
Shut up, Brandon.
You know what? Now she ain't gonna be able to sleep tonight, bro.
It ain't my fault.
I don't like that. You see, and that's what I'm saying. A real suspenseful movie get real. Like, we watched some movie, I think it was called Death. This lady was in the house, and she's a writer, but she was deaf, and this man started like fucking with her. Y'all ever seen that?
No, for real.
Y'all need to look it up. Like, her friend lived somewhere in the woods, and the friend went to visit, and he slaughtered the friend. And then her boyfriend was supposed to come, and he slaughtered the boyfriend. And he just started fucking with her when he realized she couldn't hear. And it was just, but the think about how when the movie was like based in the house, how quiet everything always was, to then the camera flashing to the outside and he whacking bitches. Listen, and Brittany had that subwoofer, so y'all, I needed like four blunts that night. I can't take that. Turn that shit down.
Like, I don't like that suspense shit. Yeah,
it get real scary real fast.
It was a movie like that. It wasn't with that, it was about an old man and he was blind, and the kids, I don't know if they was, I never watched it, but they were in his house trying to rob him or something.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
What was it called? Don't Breathe or some shit.
Yep. Yeah.
That old man was
like that, like,
whipping their ass. Boy, you in there with your damn breath stank, that motherfucker can smell your breath. He know it. I know you at, and he come in and karate chop your damn ass, boy.
Not karate chop.
Old ass white Trump supporter. That nigga look like a damn Trump supporter.
He definitely did.
You breathe too damn hard. That motherfucker, stop the steal. Come whip your damn ass.
Stop the steal.
Listen.
Hank, them motherfuckers, bruh, I had watched this shit this week, and they did like a timeline of all of the stuff that happened last Wednesday. Them motherfuckers was talking about hang Mike Pence. Mike Pence is a traitor. Hang Mike Pence. Hang Mike Pence. I'm like, God damn.
Dog, if it ain't Trump, bro, they's like, yo, it's Trump or nothing. You saw they attacked Lindsey Graham in the airport.
Yeah, they ran his ass out. But he got videotaped getting on Air Force One with Donald Trump after he said Donald Trump went too far and shit. That motherfucker be flip-flopping, dog. Jamie Harrison should have won, bro.
He definitely should have won. I shared a post on Facebook that was saying, South Carolina, you see what Georgia did? That could have been us. And I was like, yeah, that damn sure could have been, because Jamie Harrison wore my ass out. Yeah, I don't even live there no more.
Listen, he had things coming in the mail, email, in your text message, on your TV, your radio, your satellite, your iPad.
Yeah,
it ended up paying off for him, though. You see, he finna be the DNC chairperson.
Yeah, he had shit on our show. I ain't even approved that shit. It was like, hold on, be easy. This is Jamie Harrison, and I approved this message. What the fuck, nigga? I ain't paid you. Anyway.
I came home for a week, and my grandma was like, oh, you got mail? And I'm just like, why am I? It's a Young at this point. Like, that's my maiden name. Like, you can put it in the trash. There ain't nobody that need me. It was so much shit from Jamie Harrison. And that little week I was home, I was on Facebook like, can y'all please vote for this man? He don't want me out. I ain't been home but a week. He want me out.
They tried to get him in there.
They did.
But yeah, it's a whole lot of Trump supporters down here, boy. If Jamie Harrison would have won out here, they really would have been shouting stop the steal. It's a fraudulent election. What's the name of that company that had the voting booths or whatever? What was that company called? Dominion. Dominion has rigged the election. Stop the steal. Drain the swamp. They be saying all kind of shit.
Shut the fuck up, Brandon.
They try, for real, they be saying that shit. Then they try to, after that lady, Ashley Babbitt got killed, they started hashtagging, say her name. The mother was like, uh-uh, hold on, nope.
Pause.
Nah, right. they
say her name is for black women only.
Yeah, yeah, they tried to.
You could go.
Yeah, they tried to steal that shit. But yeah, we saw all that video. Did y'all know they was spreading feces and peeing all over the damn place?
Listen, I didn't know that till I read an article. I think it was earlier this week, and I was like, okay, I know they went in there and like put their foot up and was hollering and carrying on, but what was it that made you want to take the shit out of your ass and spread it around in them people facility? And I just, they low down nasty and dirty, honey. I just don't get it.
They were in there wild, and I saw some videos because, like you said, I saw some of the like the pictures and stuff and what the CNN coverage was showing. Mm-hmm. But then I like actually went on YouTube and it was like cell phone videos of folks being up in there, and they was really like wild, and it was like randomly just tearing stuff up. One dude had like this flagpole and was walking around punching holes, everything that he could punch a hole into.
Yeah, I think I saw that. Yeah, trying to smash. Like, yeah,
yeah, they was wilding for no reason, bro.
I ain't even, oh man. And the cops, what, I don't know.
Mm.
But they was talking about the night, when by the time it got to nighttime, they was whooping them people ass. They were surprised then. But it was too late then. A lot of those people though, they starting to get identified and stuff, like the guy that put his feet up on Nancy Pelosi desk, he got identified. It was one guy, he's a Olympic gold medalist. His name is
Olympic swimmer.
Cleet Keller. He won 2 gold medals. He was there. And he appeared in a video posted by a reporter, Julio Rosas, as part of a crowd surging. But he was wearing some paraphernalia, which was his Team USA jacket. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Easily identifiable.
Easily.
And that was how they got him.
I do feel like they didn't make as many arrests as I thought they were going to. Or is it that they just highlighted the ones that seem to have like big moments and others didn't have big moments? So.
Right. And I think that's what I feel like, because I saw a story about one of the guys that we had on, similar to the buddy with his Olympic jacket on. Mm-hmm. My dude wore his work badge up in there.
Yeah, I saw that.
and they got him from that. So I think there's like a lot more that are being arrested that may not have been as publicized, because the only ones they showed are the ones who they kind of like putting out there to say, oh, these guys have been arrested. But I heard Florida, like something like 30 of them, as soon as they landed, nah, come on, we got you, bro. We got a ride for you.
That's crazy.
Go ahead and put your bags down for me.
You won't be needing those for a little.
Won't be needing them.
Did we talk about the dude that had the horns on and the pelt and all of that shit with the face paint and no shirt?
We didn't talk about him, but he definitely was front and center.
Yeah, now he on some fool conspiracy theory shit, some QAnon shit. They call him Snowflake Shaman. Now he got arrested. He got arrested, and for the first couple of days he was in jail, he was on hunger strike because the food in prison was not organic and it did not agree with his diet. And so he had to get a lawyer, and the jail had to acquiesce to his wishes and get him organic food while he's in prison.
I know you fucking lie.
Privilege. Oh, excuse me.
Of course. Now, I did think that at first, but do y'all watch Orange is the New Black?
I did. I didn't keep up with it all the way through.
Now, I remember in the first season, because everything we watch on TV is definitely based on real life. But on the first season of Orange is the New Black, the dark-skinned girl, I forgot her name. I forgot.
Crazy Eyes?
No, not Crazy Eyes. The other girl.
The big one. The bigger one?
She's thick.
I'm going to say that thick. Because I can't remember her name.
Yeah. She was kind of like,
always be what Pooh saying.
Yeah, yeah, they was like best friends. I think it was her, maybe it was the other girl, but one of those two, they kind of like switched their religion and to say they were Jewish so they could get the kosher meals, because the kosher meals were better than the regular meals that they would get. So, but I know, like, if you in jail or whatever and you Muslim, it's certain shit you can't eat, and they won't give you certain shit if you Muslim. You know what I'm saying? Unless you had a hell of fire prison where they don't give a fuck and they fuck with you like that. But so, because, you know what I'm saying, out of religious grounds or whatever, if he could prove that, you know what I'm saying? But I still think it's crazy that they be calling these people snowflakes and all kind of shit like that. Well, calling everybody else snowflakes, but this motherfucker can't eat because it's not organic.
That's crazy.
His name is Jacob Anthony Chansley.
That sounds just like the name too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A lot of Jacobs.
And Chads.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Definitely Chads now. Shout out to my homeboy Chad though. He black Chad's different. It's a lot of people that think that like all of these people are poor and, you know, they're doing it because of economic anxiety and all this kind of stuff. Y'all don't believe the hype. There was this one lady, she's from Texas. She's a real estate broker from Frisco. She flew into DC. Guess how she got there, y'all?
Probably a private jet.
She got there on the PJ, beloved. Yes. Jenna Ryan, who was also a radio host, she flew from U.S. Trinity Aviation in Denton, Texas, all the way to the nation's capital, where she said she had one of the best days of her life. She put on Instagram or wherever, she said, hopping on a plane to D.C., hashtag March to Save America, hashtag guess what, y'all? Stop the steal. Hashtag stop the steal. She was tagged in a whole bunch of photos on Facebook. She even tweeted a photo with her pals aboard the jet. She said, we're going to go down and storm the Capitol. They're down there right now, and that's why we came. That's what she said in a video clip. The morning of the riots, she streamed, live streamed the walk to the Capitol Hill. And she said, all these working class people taking the week off, we flew here for freedom. They don't want to steal the election. They want to steal everything. No, she said, they want to steal the election. They want to steal everything. Now, see, the they they're talking about is not the white people on the left. Mm-hmm. They are the niggers. Courtney, you, ma'am, you are a nigger. B.C. Bud, you black African jungle bunny. You are they. You porch monkey, moon cricket, jigaboo you.
You really get on my damn nerves.
You are
last
they.
One, bro. Nerve is. This dude would be killing me.
You are they.
My thing with them, like you said, it's not just the poor ones or the hillbillies, even though especially around here in South Carolina, they deep. It's mm-hmm. it's a lot of them, bro. Like I've walked on my campus and heard conversations where and specifically heard them saying such as a Trump, and then they look up and see me coming and stop talking, bro. And yeah. These are like professionals, these are professors, doctors and stuff, you know what I mean? And so like they're afraid of losing their power. It's not about, you know yep. what I mean, old Biden and nothing like what he represents. It's the us factor and the fact that our voices are finally starting to be heard. Whether or not the Democrats are for us is a whole separate conversation. Mm-hmm. But just the fact that they see them losing the stronghold of the hundreds of years of power that they've had, and they losing their minds.
Yep. Losing their damn everlasting mind.
They lose, yeah, yeah, and that's for damn sure. They don't know what to do, how to act. They just, for them, you would think like it is really, something really traumatic is happening, and to them, the whole world is in shambles and in chaos for completely yep. other reasons than what it really is.
Yep, mm-hmm. And all they want to do, y'all, I don't know why y'all are so much against them. All they want to do is drain the damn swamp. These liberal coastal elites are ruining the good fabric of this country. And the good fabric of this country is white power. White power. Anyway. Oh, yeah, that lady got
arrested.
That lady got arrested. For
and
taking
she
part.
Should.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Did you see the one that the newly elected, whatever her name is, representative from Georgia was saying, she's like a Trump loyalist or whatever, saying she was going to introduce the papers of impeachment for Biden the day that he's sworn in?
Yeah. Yeah, somebody did. She need to lose her seat. She is incompetent. She is not fit for office. She need to lose whatever she just won.
Bruh, and it's crazy to me because she's saying that, it was stolen and all of those things were manipulated here in Georgia. But then somebody asked her, it's like, so does that mean that your election should be overturned as well? Because it was right on the same ticket that Biden was on.
She was like, yo, son, yo, like, I'm just saying, like, they need to look into that. Not mine, though.
Right. No, nah, they were just messing with her. Like, it's not mine.
but it don't work like that.
Yeah.
They wild, bro.
Yeah. It's just, I don't know, man. It's, you can't explain it. Like, it's like you sitting the information right here in front of them. Like, yeah, 2 + 2 = 4. Nah, nigga, that shit 7.
Well, how do we know that that's really a 2? I'm pretty sure that it used to be a 3, and they may have changed it when I wasn't looking.
See, the media is lying to you, because who's to say 2 + 2 isn't 5? The 2 used to be a 3, and the 3 used to be a 4. You see? Yeah, that how they them motherfuckers is crazy, dog. I don't know.
And I feel like she really is going to try, and she's going to really introduce the impeachment. She really is.
Is she going to waste people time and money?
Is she going to waste their time and money? Because it's not going to go anywhere, because there have been so many judges and so much everything and everybody have already said they have found no evidence of a stolen election. Like, how many motherfucking times these people need to say that? At this point, like, my son, even go have a seat in the I don't fucking understand corner, because it's over.
Where she need to go?
What?
In the I don't understand corner, because this shit is over. We moving on.
I can't wait till she like, you know how they be in the meetings or whatever, in the chambers of Congress or whatever, and they have, and she's I yield the floor to the lady of Georgia or whatever. I want to introduce articles of impeachment for Joe Biden, and then I want Maxine Waters to hit her with the
girl. Shut the fuck up.
That's what I want Maxine Waters to hit her with that real quick.
Because you know, Auntie Maxine don't be giving one motherfucking damn. Girl, go sit in the I don't understand corner. My life is over, and we're going to reconvene as normal, because I just feel like we've spent so much time on this shit. Like, motherfucker, this was since November, 2 months. We've been hearing motherfuckers talk about a stolen election. And did y'all hear the audio or read the audio of Trump on the phone with motherfuckers in Georgia? Yeah. Like, all I need is a couple. All I need. Nigga,
this nigga said the exact amount. He was like,
right.
It was like he was ordering some them Reeboks and shit. They call them 5411s. They're 5411s because there's $54.11. He knew the exact. Yeah, I need. You sure you can't find 11,332 votes?
Right.
You telling
it's
me
only
that?
X, Y, and Z. What are they supposed to find them from? Because these motherfuckers ain't voted for you, sir. Like,
you know the crazy shit is though. Like, that wasn't the only motherfucker he called.
Right.
He called Arizona. The motherfucker called Pennsylvania. Now, Pennsylvania, yeah, we need 53,272 votes. Like, he knew the exact number. Like, you sure we can't? Like, he wanted him to win by one and shit.
My thing is, how you just feel like you could just call up people and they were supposed to respond like, oh, that's all you need? All right, bet, we got it. But this ain't Scandal. You ain't got no Olivia motherfucking Pope. You lost.
It might be.
Sit down.
It might be Scandal. Like, that's the crazy shit is, like, you don't know, like, how much other shit that he had effects on, and he was just making calls like, yo, I need this done, I need that done. Like, this was just the one motherfucker who had the balls to, you know, show out, because I think the guy that he called was a Republican. And a lot of them people, they kind of like backing away from him because they know he going to be out of power. Some people still trying to stand with him because they don't want to lose their, you know, those followers, those crazy Trump followers or whatever. But a lot of people, they
are distancing themselves.
Yeah, they trying to. That shit ain't going to work, because them people going to remember. like I think I said this last week, people did the same shit with Obama, like in his last term, like the last midterm election, whatever, when he really didn't have no power. So they started talking shit about what he didn't do. And a lot of those people, they tried to do that to, like, you know, get favor with Trump supporters or other people or whatever. But it didn't work. They got voted out. You know what I'm saying? When all they had to do was, you know, stay with the Democrats or whatever, stay with whoever, and they probably would have won their seats again just because motherfuckers just vote down ticket or whatever. But these people who are backing away, like y'all said earlier, they chased Lindsey Graham through the airport. Now that motherfucker had a haul ass and shit. Nigga was running. He was running like O.J. Simpson was behind him or something. Go ahead, O.J. Go on with that bull. Now that's a scary motherfucker right there. You seen how that nigga walk
with the slide?
Hell yeah, man. Shit, OJ, chill out, nigga. I'm gonna shoot you in your knee, dog. Chill out, bro. Hey, Jules. Oh, hey, man.
Yeah, somebody, with that dumb stuff now.
Yeah, hey, somebody come get Jules now. Yeah.
Now, I might be mistaken, but if I'm recalling correctly, mm-hmm. the only reason that Trump even got caught with the call was because he called the wrong dude. So in my mind, like, who's to say he ain't did this on the first go round? It's like, listen, y'all out there in these elections, I need
that is right.
Place. I need mm-hmm. that many from this place. And I'm saying he had his people coming through. Like, at this point, he's just sick of him, you know what I mean? And so his stink is to a point where, like I said, even his people are like, all right, bro, you got the slide, dog. We done with you. But the first time around, when they thought he was going to be all butter and all for them, he could have been making it, like y'all said, on some scandals type status, making all that stuff happen on the first mm-hmm. go round. And that's the only reason this nigga even the president from the jump.
You know what else? What you just said reminded me too. It was one politician that came out. Now, he didn't say that what Trump said on the call and what he was trying to do was despicable. This motherfucker, he questioned the character of the person that released the call. He was like, what type of person would release a private call? Like, something is wrong with their character and all kind of shit. Like, mm-hmm. you missing the forest from the trees, cuz. Like, what the
because
fuck?
If,
like,
trees from because the forest, here's the thing. Though. We all know that if Obama had ever had a call like that,
oh,
hell, even Clinton, because they didn't like his ass either. It would have been, man, listen.
Bruh, they was up in arms about Obama wearing a tan suit.
A suit, bro.
A suit.
Michelle Obama's shoulders are up. I do declare.
Right.
She does not represent what the first lady's office should. They should just get out of it. Meanwhile, your man out here grabbing on chicks, out here talking about handicapped folk, bro.
Like, this dude has been the trashiest elected official ever. I can't even say trashiest president, bro. Like, elected official ever, bro.
He has no tact, no class. He is stupid. He is the epitome. I really, really think, like, what? He has peanuts floating around in his head.
Nah,
that's
I'm
what
a,
I feel
no,
like.
I, well, I ain't gonna call him stupid. I ain't gonna call him stupid because he's smart enough to manipulate. Maybe that's part of narcissism, though. But he's
that
smart
is
enough.
Part
to,
of narcissism.
He's smart
narcissism.
Enough to manipulate all of these people.
But here's the thing.
I wish I had it in me. I manipulate y'all. I wish I could was smart enough to manipulate y'all to email us at djblazeshow@gmail.com. Just want to say that. Just email the show. Maybe I got to start picking at slow people. What's the term? Give me a term. Handicapable people.
Handicapable.
Yeah, I need to pick at handicapable people and start lying. It'll be a lie that I've been grabbing women by the pussy. I don't do that. Maybe I need to do that.
All I know is he was on video, and I'm still trying to find the video, saying that he was going to put an end to 9-month pregnancies because it's too long. And the moment his ass said that, I knew he had peanuts floating around in there.
Yeah.
I don't give a damn how good you are at manipulating a motherfucker. If you think you can end a knot, honey, let's just move on, because I can't even get in.
Yeah,
I feel myself just going.
They should have known he was bullshit when he said 2 Corinthians. but you know, I think in this part of the presidency, well, no, it wouldn't be lame duck. I think lame duck when you only the president and you don't got the House and the Senate or some shit like that. But anyway, he's doing whatever he can. His administration, you know, they throwing their temper tantrum, and one way they throwing their temper tantrum is basically killing everybody on death row. You know, he killed that it was that one guy they were trying to get like a stay or whatever. Was he in Texas? Where was that guy at?
I cannot remember.
It was like a gang. They say he did it. It was like involved in some gang shit or whatever. That made the news. Well, the last of his killing spree happened this week with him killing Dustin Higgs. He was a 48-year-old Maryland man. He maintained his innocence up until his death. He was the 13th and final person executed during Trump's term. Now, he got executed this morning. Shortly after the Supreme Court lifted a stay from a lower court, they killed him with lethal injection. His lawyers wanted to stop it because the guy had COVID and he had lung damage, and so they said that the lethal injection would be extraordinarily painful because of the COVID. They wanted him to delay it until his lungs recovered. But he was pronounced dead at 1:23 in Terre Haute, Indiana. Now just this week, he killed three people. Lisa Montgomery, she was the only woman on federal death row. She was killed Wednesday morning. And Corey Johnson, who had an intellectual disability and was also recovering from COVID-19. He was put to death Thursday. And these final two occurred after he was impeached for the second time.
That's crazy, isn't
it? Yeah. Like, of all the shit you could do, why choose to kill people? I wouldn't be doing
display of power. He just wanna do whatever it is he got the power to do. And also, we know he having the biggest temper tantrum of all time right now. Mm-hmm. And this how he gonna act it out.
Same reason he out here pardoning all of his buddies and golf pals, and even some of these cats from the Capitol storming. He trying to pardon them on his way out. He trying to find ways to pardon himself from the ignorance that he done, bro. Like, it's
he is. I saw a meme that was like, damn, Trump's stupid because now he done pardon everybody. When his ass get locked up on the 22nd, he ain't going to have none of his buddies in jail with him. I thought about that shit. Matter of fact, I didn't see that online. My brother, who is incarcerated, called me and was like, yeah, we were sitting down talking like, damn, this nigga, like them in the whatever, watching TV, was talking about that and said that. And I was like, damn, y'all right. Like, y'all up in there putting y'all hands together. Y'all is right. He ain't going to have no buddies with him in jail.
Okay, this is totally unrelated. Do your brother listen to the show?
He can't. So they only have certain podcasts on the iPads preloaded that they can listen to, and ours isn't one of them. And I don't know how to go about
getting on that list. Probably because I cuss too much.
That list.
And I be talking about drugs.
I don't know how to go about it. He did say they did just recently. He had access or has access to Breakfast Club, so he listens to that. And they just got access to Friend Zone. But other than that, he said he wasn't really listening to anything other than Breakfast Club because none of them on there were really like representative of us or something that he would want to listen to.
See, man, they need to get us on the. Tell your brother I'm the damn one who got all the internet
access. Because his internet stuff is definitely preloaded on his iPad. He was the one told me, like, how can y'all go about finding out how y'all can get on the prison?
How can I? How can you holler at me? You send us a damn message. Let us know. Shit. Tell them motherfuckers who got iPad. Hey, man, I want to listen to this other podcast. And they really for the community and all of that. The girl on there, she do a lot of drugs, though, but that might not be good.
Oh, wow. not the girl on there, doing drugs.
Both of the girls to be on there be doing drugs.
You smoking shut weed up. And things.
One thing that Trump, I don't know, I get, well, this falling past him, though.
Well, shit.
Y'all file y'all taxes?
No.
Nope.
Like 2021?
Yeah.
Nah,
I didn't do that yet. Well, don't be in no rush because the IRS recently confirmed that the start of the 2021 tax filing season has now been delayed until early February.
Well, damn.
Yep, many Americans are not going to like the recent news from the IRS.
They're definitely going to be pissed off, especially the same ones who can't get their stimulus until they file.
Who is that?
Gonna be real. There are certain people that they said the IRS, there's a certain date that they put out. And if you don't have like any, if you don't have it by then, and if it comes up on the website when you try to track it, it says not available or one other error or message people are getting, then you have to file it with your taxes. That happened to my brother and sister. When they go online, there it says not available. And then when she called, they said, you guys are going to have to wait to file it with your taxes. And I think the cutoff was January 15th, unless it had been extended.
Now, do they have to file this year taxes or last year taxes?
No, this year, because you supposed to have already filed last year's to this point.
But well, shit, I ain't gonna even lie. I ain't gonna tell my business like that. Just know, the thing that got me to file my taxes last year was the fact that everybody was getting stimulus. I was like, damn.
Let me go get some of this free money.
Because I know my shit was behind. I mean, I know I was going to have to pay.
That's how Brittany do. Like, we had actually got our stimulus first. And Brittany was like, shit, let's go ahead and file these taxes while we got money like we wouldn't have normally had. So in a nutshell, like us paying is almost like it ain't even coming out of our pockets. And we was like, hell yeah, go on, do that shit. But we got state back, like from New York State. But we had to pay federal.
Oh, well, it's a reason why, though, y'all. The IRS stated that the start date for individual tax return filers will allow them to do additional programming and testing following the December 27th tax law changes, which provided a second round of COVID-19 stimulus relief checks and other benefits. Okay. All right, we'll take your time, y'all.
Just take your time.
But here come the bullshit. The April 15th tax filing deadline still remains. What kind of bullshit is that?
That's giving crazy people less time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, hopefully they'll be sensible. Well, hopefully they'll be sensible and actually extend that too. Yeah. They did extend it last year too, didn't they?
They did extend it last year. It got extended to like June.
Oh yeah. Okay. Well, then I ain't filed my shit late. Then I'm gonna erase that last part then, cause
they did extend it until June. I think they're gonna end up extending it again anyway, even if it's not until the new administration gets in the office.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of the new administration getting into the office, everybody talking about that STEMI.
Mm-hmm.
But not just the $600 we supposed to get, but also more money. Now, Joe Biden, he proposes now, see, they just making up fucking numbers of money. $1.9 trillion. Where the fuck y'all getting this money from? Y'all ain't got this damn money. Y'all ass bit. America credit bad as hell. I'm sorry, y'all.
The credit so bad.
Our credit bad as hell, dog.
That's why we have to keep being friends with China, because our credit is so bad.
They hate China.
We be borrowing money from
them. Yeah. China to us is our sugar daddy.
Facts.
You don't want to holler at China. You don't want to holler at your sugar daddy. But you want to go to the club this weekend. And you took off 2 days. You ain't got 40 hours. You work 24 hours this week, and that check ain't gonna be right. So now you got to go to your sugar daddy, and now you got to do something strange for a piece of change.
Period. You're going to have to pop that thing.
Because we ain't got $1.9 trillion. But yeah, he proposes a $1.9 trillion COVID vaccination and economic package. Yes, he revealed his plans for almost blah, blah, blah. I just said that. It'll provide a nationwide vaccination effort and provide direct economic relief to Americans amid the coronavirus pandemic. The American Rescue Plan will include allocating $400 billion toward addressing the COVID-19 pandemic, including $160 billion in funding to execute a national vaccination program, expand testing, and mobilize a public health jobs program, among other measures. That's not all. Y'all saw them big numbers? The $160 billion, $400 billion. Guess how much he want to give us to all of the Americans?
$2,000.
$1,400, because you already got $600 from Trump. Don't ask me for no more money. You just get what you need. Get this $1,400 now. shit, it ain't like it's our fault that this pandemic has run amok, because we didn't have things in places. That's up to you. We told you to wear your mask and stay 6 feet apart. It was your fault. So we're only giving you $1,400, including a $400 weekly unemployment insurance supplement through September. What else? He's also, it said, because, you know, you're supposed to get $2,000, but then, you know, Mitch McConnell, his bitch ass blocked it. They say that man look like that turtle.
He do.
But anyway, so, you know, you get the 14 with the six, that add up to 2,000. Y'all know how to do math. Also, okay. He spoke to Congress about his commitment to raise the minimum wage to $15 an hour. Now, while there has been some opposition from Republicans, he pointed out that Florida, a Republican-led state, say it just passed an amendment raising its minimum wage to $15 an hour. He said no one working 40 hours a week should live below the poverty line. I agree.
I agree, because what people be making, and I just... It's just real sad that that's what they be expecting.
Listen,
that's a whole other...
What is the minimum wage now? I'm sorry, I don't know.
Sim feeding.
So I'm going to say this, and this, Sim, I don't know if this is my unpopular opinion or not.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Oh, shit.
Nah, there are some folks that don't deserve $15 an hour, bruh.
Who don't deserve it?
The folks who be in them jobs not caring about nothing, not doing no work. Like, and I'm not even just put it on like young kids. There are some grown old people who be in these jobs not even appreciating it.
You mean like the president? Trash. You mean like the president?
Like this dude don't deserve whatever the salary they're giving him. You know what I mean? But like, there's some folks who be hard down, you know what I mean, in these jobs, not caring about nothing and be trash.
But that ain't
like legit garbage, bro.
That's the uncontrolled variable. At the end of the day, there are people that still work those jobs that do more than what they're asked, that go above and beyond, that definitely deserve it. And so overall, you can't account like every single, and also most of the time the people that are shitty, they don't come in the interview like that. They come in the interview promising, and then they get comfortable or they just be annoyed and what have you. You can't, an employer can't predict how an employee is going to be, and you got to give them, I just still feel like it should still be $15. It should be more than $15 if you ask me.
Yeah, it really should.
But $15 is definitely a start, because you got to think $15 an hour time, 80 hours a week, and in especially in certain places where you live, and you're still going to be at a mark of I'm just making it, paying your rent, paying your car insurance, paying your car note if you have one, light bill, water bill, cell phone bill, because you got to have some type of communication. Internet, these kids be having to work from home, people be having kids, like it's a lot. We ain't even hit groceries yet, and how we already know, especially South Carolina specifically, some motherfuckers start making $15 an hour, you can just cut that food stamp shit short. South Carolina don't be wanting to give a motherfuckers no E, B, or T. Okay. people need that. It don't matter.
Well, let me ask you this question, because I just did the quick math real quick. Shout out to my iPhone calculator. $15 an hour is $28,800 a year if you're working your 40 a week. There are individuals, there's a matter of fact, I'm gonna just put it out there. There's a position at the University of South Carolina's Aiken campus for a college recruiter where you have to have a 4-year degree to work there. And they were starting the position off at $29,000. So what you're basically telling me is some 18, 19 year old kid who don't really care nothing about nothing can start off with his first job at McDonald's making the same amount of money as somebody who's gone through 4 years of college and spends it up to sometimes 20 days a month on the road recruiting to get people to come to college.
Absolutely, because the salary for that should be higher, and that's just point blank. You can't tell someone I require 4 years and then tell them you can't even start these. You want 4 years. You want these people to get a degree, which they're gonna get in hella debt for potentially, and you can't even get them $30,000. You can't even get. I don't have I have certifications, but I don't have an official degree. And baby, I make more than that, and that is where the problem lies. it ain't in that the 19, the 17, 18, 19 year old shouldn't be able to make that. It's that you shouldn't be requiring someone to come to your job with a degree. So, you know, to a certain degree, they already have debt, and then tell them you only give them 29. Honey, they could go work at the McDonald's and have less responsibility at $15 an hour and make the same. Why would I give myself more stress in doing this job for you when I'm not getting no more than someone else at the Zaxby's? That job needs to be offering more. And that's when Mary had a little motherfucking lamb.
Now, and I mean, I'm not going to argue with your point or the perspective that you're coming from. I will say it feels a little idealistic because at the end of the day, yes, if for whatever reason they're able to raise that minimum wage up to $15, we're not going to see a upwards tick around the board, because at that point then it alleviates the purpose of raising that minimum wage. And so what's going to happen is you're going to see exactly that, them cheap low jobs. No, I won't say cheap. Let me rephrase that. The introductory worker level jobs making that money is going to be on the same par with that. And so you're going to see the decline in the skilled laborers or in the people going to college for those types of jobs and everything else, because they're not going to raise those wages. Just if they take that time and raise the minimum, they're not going to raise those other ones too. So you're just going to be creating even a greater depth or a greater separatism from those jobs and the other ones.
But why do you think there'll be a decline? Like, it's a lot of jobs that require you to have a degree, and people go into those jobs knowing that they're not going to make a lot of money, like education, like teachers in high schools and stuff like that, and elementary and stuff. But people still choose those jobs. They know that they're not going to make as much money as like a truck driver or something like that. But people still do those jobs.
The trash man in New York State, the trash man make hella money.
Mm-hmm. But I mean, so the people will still do those jobs.
I think what you're talking about, Brandon, also reverts back to the passion of it. Like, so I feel like, especially now, or the teachers that I see or that I'm surrounded by, they do it because they absolutely want to do it. Like, they know they don't get the compensation, but it's the service of it. And they remember how teachers affected them growing up. And also, there are some people that just like, there needs to just honestly be more of us in those positions. And I think that will be the difference. It's just like people that go into social work, or they know that they're not going to be compensated, but it's the service. Some people really want to provide and or get they feel
the intrinsic reward.
Yes, that when they are being of service, and those are service ass jobs.
I just don't think that, like, because like every time like the minimum wage raising comes up, like that topic, people always equate that $15 an hour to fast food workers. But it's a lot of people that work at plants that build cars and things like that. Like, a lot of these places don't make $15 an hour. They might start out like 12 or 13, you know what I'm saying? 11. I worked at one where that shit started out at 11.64.
So,
you know what I'm saying? So,
go ahead.
But I mean, it's a wide variety of job. Like, we was talking about that Cardi B movie or whatever. Like, them people that work in them nursing homes, assisted living facilities and stuff, a lot of them don't start out making no $15 an hour. Now, you got to take care of your mima or granny, Nana, and she make $12 an hour. That's why she be pushing Nana down on the damn bed. She mad. Oh,
wow.
Hell yeah. So
only getting $10 an hour worth of service out of me today.
Yeah, you can get a better quality person working there if you paying a little bit more. Like you say, $15 an hour for 40 hours a week, what, $28,000 a year? That ain't a lot of money anyway.
That is not a lot of money, because you get that a year, but then that also ain't counting what they finna tax you.
Yep.
You still gotta pay taxes on that amount. And then you still got stuff that you have to pay literally every single month. Every single month, you gotta pay that rent. You have to pay your car insurance. Everyone wish they could live in New Hampshire where you don't have to have car insurance. In New Hampshire, you don't have to have shit. They slogan is live free or die. They mean that shit.
You don't gotta have car insurance?
No, not in New Hampshire. No, live free or die.
New Hampshire, you say.
Huh? Yeah.
New Hampshire, you say. Okay.
Damn.
Yeah. No, you don't have to have none of that around here. New Hampshire is literally the free. They free as fuck out there.
You know,
and
I don't
niggas
think...
living up there?
No, you said what? No niggas living up there.
I mean, there's some.
Yeah, they work, work at McDonald's.
Want to be doing.
They work at McDonald's making $7.25 an hour. That's why you'll never see them no damn way.
Hey. Shut
They're working 80 hours a week. Courtney said 80 hours a week. They're working 80 hours a week trying to make ends meet.
I mean, so they can't go to every 2 weeks.
I know what you meant.
And I'm not trying to just, like, you know, put the light on McDonald's. That's literally just what I thought of. But you are right about plants and all of that. I mean, but at the end of the day, all those people, a lot of times, though, I think I revert to McDonald's or fast food because to a certain degree, those places are for sure like at a minimum wage. And even if plants aren't paying what's worthy, because motherfuckers work in the plant, a lot of times they work hard as hell, but they ain't in the plant making $7.50 or $8. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They are still a step above. But I do feel like if they, I'm going to just leave.
Yeah, that's why they had to hire like a lot of ex-dope boys that trying to get their life together to work in these plants now because they ain't paying regular people that much money and they that turnover. But now they got all them old dope boys working in the damn plants.
Because they got to get on the straight and narrow.
Yep. Walking around in the mall with them damn suits on. I be seeing y'all boys. I be saying y'all boys. They be proud too. It ain't nothing like a dope boy and he trying to get his life right. He got a square job. Well, that boy, that motherfucker wears his uniform to the damn mall. He mm-hmm. at the damn barbershop when he get off.
Proud of their job.
Hell yeah.
You know, I ain't even gonna lie. I used to see it all the time, especially working in the mall. And I used to just be like, them plant niggas be loving their job. Or they love a motherfucker to know they work at the plant and they got them benefits and doing whatever.
With that all white on. Y'all know what plant I'm talking about. With that all white on.
I guess with working in education for as long as I did, higher ed specifically, I've seen a decline in the intrinsic workers that you was talking about just a second ago mm-hmm. with the people who want to become teachers because, oh, I remember this best teacher that I had in the third grade, or the ones who want to be social workers because you saw a family getting broken up. There's people like I've been in this for 10 years in higher ed, and I originally got into it because of a recruiter that recruited me to college. And so I was one of the intrinsic workers. But after having gone through it for 10 years, gotten my master's in the field and loving it, I'm at a point where, okay, yeah, I still love it and I like making a difference, but the higher I move up into leadership, it's like, ain't no money here, bro. And so I'm at a point where I'm looking at my other options like, at the end of the day, I don't want to be, you know what I'm saying? I'm not like living check to check right now, but I'm also not, hey, I think I want to go out tomorrow and buy a boat. You know what I mean? So like to be able to get to that point, that means I'm going to have to do something different. And so there's a lot of folks who I see, even with teachers, like there's a decline in education. Social work, we had to close one of our majors at the school I worked for because there wasn't nobody simply going into the major. Damn. It's a lot more people who are going to, if the federal minimum wage is raised to $15 an hour, and they can make what they consider good money, you know what I'm saying, from their perspectives, and not have to go through a four-year degree, they're going to do it. Just like there's been a rise in people for a while going into tech jobs and other stuff, not having to go into four-year degrees. They're not going to do that if they can go make $15 an hour working at the plant. And like you said, showing off and stunting and them boy all white. So,
and to a certain degree, I agree with that because they have to figure out a way to have the compensation there, like make the long-term schooling and the debt, make it make sense, like make it have some validity, or let us be able to go to school and obtain these things
without the debt.
And not have to get in all that debt. Because here's the thing for me. I've had a lot of jobs. And there have been a lot of jobs where I should have had degrees for said jobs. And I've even had people, you know, them come up to me and be like, we typically require a degree for this job. However, we're going to go ahead and offer you this job. I've definitely been told that. So I have never honestly felt a need to get a degree. And I have definitely racked up the student loan debt because I would always change my major. Because I'm interested in a lot of different things. I don't want to commit myself to just one thing. There isn't just one thing that I love so much that I may want to do absolutely forever. I want to do this, and that. And also because there's some jobs when we first moved to New York, I was like, damn, in order to be like they, in order to work at the call center, they want you to have a bachelor's to work at the call center. You know how many call centers I've worked at?
Wow.
Like, to make it make sense. And then that's when it comes into the area of you want me to have all of this when you up here and you're still going to pay me down here. And excuse me, Brittany's outside looking at me in through the window. And you're still going to pay me down here. You're such a creep. And still pay me down here. Y'all, sorry, I'm blushing because I can't even.
Ow!
That damn bad tooth ain't hurting eyes. She ready. She ready for that sushi.
Let me find out. She going to have to take a little pause real quick. Yeah,
she ready for y'all that so- sushi.
Y'all know that sushi. Anyway, and then, but then also too, like the jobs that we, I feel like require degrees sometimes when you come in and you have that degree, it's like, yep, you got a degree, you're qualified. We gave you this job. Here come a whole Empire State Building worth of work. People don't want to be overworked like that. Like, I come in here, I got the degree, you're paying me, but I can't even take the vacation time that I need to be taking because you worked me too hard. But if I go around the corner to the call center that is paying me the same, I got time I can put in. It just is about balance. And it is just isn't a lot of balance and or fairness as it pertains to any of this, any of the roads you can go down when you start talking about minimum wage and what it should be versus what it shouldn't be and how it affects the others.
Stop the because damn steal.
All of these things are true.
Stop everything the damn steal. Everything is.
I'm so glad Brittany gone, y'all. I couldn't hardly focus. That's so crazy. I was blushing like that.
Damn. She's a little razzle dazzled.
I know, right? Mm-hmm. Anyway, we're moving on.
Yes, we are. Something that has me razzle dazzled. I saw this maybe last week. This girl fool. Now, Azalea Banks.
She's so fool.
A few years ago, she had like some dead cat bones, chicken bones in her closet. And they was in there so long, like the blood stains and turned black and burgundy and all. It was crazy. This time, she had a video clip of her and her unknown friend digging up a dead cat. Yeah, she shared a video of them digging up the dead cat, and she was laughing in the background. She made up a rap about it on the spot.
Not a rap about it on the spot. Talking about
the cat is in the bag. I'm sorry.
Oh my goodness.
And she captured the post, Lucifer. She named her cat Lucifer. This was the caption, Lucifer, 2009 to 2020. Damn, that cat lived a long life. That's a long time for a cat, ain't it?
Well, you know, I think cats do live a long time.
My dear kitty, thank you for everything, a legend, an icon, forever, serve. What? Says she wasn't done there, and she then proceeds to apparently, what? Ball the dead cat as another post shows her over a big pot. What the hell is wrong with this girl?
Everybody knows Azalea be practicing.
Yeah, she shared it on her Instagram stories, but then she took it down quickly. And somebody on Twitter said, I genuinely hope girl gets help one day, but God damn. What in the hell is wrong with her? Another person added, my stomach is in my mouth right now. She should really speak to a psychologist. This is one of the first tweets I saw this morning, and I think I'm already going to log off. I can't believe that. She bought a damn dead cat. What the fuck is... I remember when she was on Wild
Peroxide.
Huh?
I said, when I saw, she boiled it into peroxide so she could take it to the jewelers to make the jewelry out of it, bro. Like,
oh. So what she was
not boiled it in peroxide.
Why?
Yeah. Something that about, like she's saying, oh, that's how the taxidermists do. And so I'm looking to try to preserve it as much as possible and get it clean so that they can form it and fashion it into jewelry. Like, she made some earrings out of the jaw, bro.
Oh, okay. Well, okay. Shit.
No, ain't no okay. That's still right. Creepy. No, why is that okay for you now, bro?
I mean, you balling the cat for a reason. Now, Did anybody just want to just ball a damn cat just to ball a cat? But if you ball a cat because I'm going to make me a damn rope. All right, shit, you know what I'm saying?
Public service announcement. Shout there out. Is no acceptable reason to boil a dead cat, bruh. None.
Y'all boys be walking around with crosses around y'all neck, and that's where they got the blood of Christ from. But I can't ball Fluffy. I want a Garfield chain. Y'all can't wear Garfield. Heathcliff. I want Heathcliff around my damn neck. Y'all can't do that.
Nah, dead. Wow. Like, I can see if maybe if when the cat first died, she decided, oh, I want to do something with him to remember him. But you done buried this cat. And then after it's in the ground to the point where it's just bones, you're like, oh, wait, I might want to wear him now.
You want to know what she did to that cat?
What she did to the cat, bro?
She planted it. Oh, I bring that shit back full circle, nigga. y'all. Yeah, she's a weirdo.
Smoking on Lucifer tonight.
Yeah, we smoking on that loot. I ain't saying that. Hell no.
Hell no.
I don't know. Nope. I don't know about that.
Nope. Won't get me.
I got an update on one story we did, y'all, before we get out of here. Y'all remember we talked about my man from Pretty Ricky a while ago? Did we talk about him?
The one that's in jail for that fraud.
Yeah. He got indicted.
Oh, wow.
Baby Blue. He was involved in a $24 million COVID relief scheme. He got arrested for wire fraud, bank fraud, and a conspiracy to commit wire fraud and bank. Hold up. If I committed it, how am I getting arrested for conspiracy to commit and I'm in there for doing it? That don't make no sense to me.
That's how they always stack all them charges up against people all the time. They find the loopholes and they stack as many charges as they can.
You thought about it, you planned it, and you did it. We're going to charge you triple.
For every part of the process.
So he's been indicted. I know he got the charge, but he's been indicted. And so that was just an update on my favorite segment, which is Scam of the Week. Now, these new scammers I got, y'all, they're kind of close to home. If this shit will pull up. I want to say this happened in Columbia, South Carolina. Two victims were allegedly
My bad guys. I thought my phone was on do not disturb. My apologies, friends.
That's your warning. It said two victims were allegedly scammed out of $55,000 by two people who offered a franchise opportunity for Noisy Wings Restaurant, according to Columbia Police Department. The incident happened on October 24, 2020 at the Noisy Wings Restaurant at 905 Bluff Road in Columbia. According to the incident report obtained by Watch Fox News, Tykesha Jones.
Oh, Lord.
Cousin.
And D'Angela Lassiter met with Dennis R. Gadsden and Shannon Nicole Green Thomas. Damn, bitch, you got four names. On Bluff Road to give the suspects $30,000 in cash and a $25,000 check for franchise rights to operate Noisy Wings locations. If y'all see a picture of this, I thought it was Braids, but she don't look like she a franchise of shit with that damn badass weave.
A franchise. You sound the disgust in your voice almost is like how Britney be looking at people when she sees someone with a bad weave. She can't stand a bad fucking weave.
One location was in Lexington and one location was in North Augusta, according to the department. When the women attempted to get the keys to open the businesses, they learned both were owned and rented by other businesses. The victims tried to contact Gasson and Thomas, who refused to respond or refund the money. We sent emails for them to give us our money back, and it was nothing. It came back with nothing. The last email was not to contact them in the month. Man, stop. You aggravating me. This is my money now. you snooze, you lose. Yeah. Thomas was arrested on December 21st for two counts of obtaining goods under false pretenses, over $10,000. Gasson was arrested the next day on the same charges. He said they are still advertising for franchising. We would just tell people to be careful. Be careful. There are really people out here trying to take your money, said Jones. Gasson was the owner and operator of Noisy Wings Restaurant on Bluff Road at the time of the allegation.
Wow.
Well, at least they got arrested. Hopefully these people get their $55,000 back.
I'm just confused at how they thought they weren't going to be arrested.
Child, I don't know.
Like, how did you think that people weren't going to go to the media or go press charges about $55,000?
Man, that's my $20 now. No, bro, that's 55 grand now.
Right. Like, in a pandemic?
Yep. And now?
They ain't broke.
They gave you all the damn money up. No.
Not listen, anymore. You got to chill, bro.
Oh, man.
Well, I guess we know where the money reside.
listen, with the scammers, still.
Man, they still out here scamming, getting over.
They gon' scam, baby. That's the scammers gon' scam. Yep.
And that's not even like creative, because like you said, there's no deniability. There's no, oh, well, we thought this. Or, nah, you just was like, yo, we got this. Psych, got your money, bye.
Right, like, bruh. At least now you stupid.
They might can get the check money back though, because that was $25,000 in check money. So at least they ain't all the way out of money. But
nigga, run me my motherfucking cash, the 30 bands.
And we live in the same. Like, I could see if it was internet shit. If it was some internet shit, you know, you got to charge that to the game and put that on yourself. But these niggas that live around here.
Right. You the actual owner of the restaurant.
Yeah.
I'd have been in that restaurant.
They know your real name.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, I'm a put a whole bunch of rutches in there and shit. I'm gonna fuck your whole life up.
Listen, anything that I can do, I'm gonna do. You gonna be so sick of me and everything malicious or whatever else I'm doing, you gonna run me my money back. And that's on Mary Helena. It ain't gonna be worth the hassle for you. It ain't gonna be worth the hassle, because that's why I stay out the way, because I have boundaries and people be having boundaries and I don't. Once it's game on, baby. I'm going to run you ragged.
That's on Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, nigga.
Period. Yeah.
Somebody told me they was going back. I forgot who that was.
It was me and Brittany.
That was you. Oh, that was y'all. Yeah. Talking about that's going back and forth with nursery rhyme songs.
Yeah, I was. We was sleepy as fuck and we couldn't fall asleep and we was going back and forth. And I was winning. And then Brittany said, and that song, this is a song that doesn't end. And bitch, I lost.
That ain't no nursery rhyme though. So technically you won.
But it is. That's what we watched after the school. This is a song. Well, so it was just more or less like.
I know what you're saying. I'm just fucking with you.
I was finna say, because listen, now in my mind, I'm like, ooh, bitch, after this, I'm going to go back and be like, you didn't win. Start that shit up again.
Yeah. Well, y'all, that'll bring our show to the end, but you know we do our last segment, Courtney's favorite segment.
Yo.
Unpopular opinion. Courtney, you got an unpopular opinion for today?
You know I do.
What's your unpopular opinion today?
My unpopular opinion, and I don't feel like you guys are going to think it's unpopular, but listen, when it is, my unpopular opinion is people be married. They don't be dead. And you can be married and be a goddamn hoochie, okay? People do not have to ask permission to be hoochies from their spouses.
Shit.
This
is an unpopular opinion over here. Go ahead, continue.
I just feel like for me, you still, even in a marriage and relationship, you have to maintain your individuality. And if you were a hoochie and this person came and still pursued you, just because you married, that don't mean you ain't a hoochie. I'm just a married hoochie at this point.
Hoochie coochie la la la. I know where this came from. This
from
came from
how,
can I let me why you stole my thunder? Damn, Gina.
Because you have all the thunder. You always have all the thunder on the show.
I'm sorry. You got to bring your own damn thunder then. Shit.
It's my challenge. It is my thunder. Well, not my challenge, but I posted it.
Girl, I got the lightning and the thunder. You better bring the rain or something then. But this is where this came from. Like you said, it came from your challenge. But not only that, it came from people. Hear your messages like, your wife let you do that?
Yes, that burns me up every time, because anyone that know me know, especially if you're on my Snapchat, I will post like sexy pictures every now and then, and or thirst trapping, as you know we like to call it, and I do it for me. Like, I be feeling good. I don't always, even still to this day, feel like as good about my body. Bitches be having so, it's self-esteem issues sometimes. We be having body image issues sometimes. And so in those moments that I don't, yes, I want to celebrate it. And yeah, you get to look at it. Look. And you can even send some hard eyes or the licking out tongue. You can send whatever you want because I'm going to ignore all that. But don't ask me if Britney let me because, bitch, I'm grown. Okay?
You know what I thought when I first saw that and you had that green on? I said, I know damn well she ain't about, oh, Lord. Britney let her do that?
No, you didn't. That is not what you thought.
I tried to tap so hard from the damn end of that shit, I damn bust a hole in my damn phone trying to tap. What the hell is going on here?
Britney was the one that did the video, and that's the other thing.
Of course.
A lot of times when I take pictures, Britney is the one, she either is like, oh, you should wear your outfit like this, or oh, you should do your hair like this, or she's the one taking the picture, she's the one picking if there's a bunch of pictures. She be behind me with all of that because she know I could put my whole ass on the internet, as I did in Mexico in my thong bikini, and she know that. I still ain't checking for a motherfucking soul other than her. Ain't nothing a motherfucker out here gonna offer me that I don't already get or got in what I have with her.
Y'all want to know why Courtney
be hoochies?
Y'all don't believe period. Don't believe Courtney. Courtney is half hoochie. You want to know why?
I'm whole.
No, you ain't. Go back and watch that video again, because when that damn shirt or whatever the hell you was had that on was started to come up, she pulled that shit right back down. A whole hoochie and let that shit ride. Go back and watch that video.
So this, because that video wasn't for that. Hoochie. That video wasn't for that. But my ass has definitely been online again. Thong bikini, any bikini, I be twerking in boy shorts. And like, listen, my ass has had enough time online. That the busted challenge wasn't the time.
That would be the name of this episode: half hoochie. You're a half hoochie. You ain't a whole hoochie.
Anything, anybody know, one thing Courtney gonna do, Courtney ass gonna be out and them nips gonna be on display. And that's on Mary Had a Little Lamb. Let married folks be. They don't be having to ask for permission. And because also I know when I'm going too far, because I either be like, all right, Britney gonna be like, chill. Or if she right there, she just be looking at me like, all right. Like, if it is a thing that is too far.
That's why she was looking at your ass through the damn window. She know you be doing too damn much.
No, she was looking at me at the window because she loves me and she was flirting with me.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, that's my unpopular opinion. Married folks can do the same hoochie shit that the single hoochies do. And I feel like, and I know it depends on the relationship that you have with your spouse, significant other, et cetera, because there are a lot of people that are just like, my girl could never, my girl ain't ever. That's you and your controlling whatever.
Yeah, you're damn sure right. The only hoochie in we doing is going to Hoochie Burger. That's it.
Brandy, you aren't being serious. There's no way that I believe you.
Shit, I wish a motherfucker will.
Your girl, so you got a girl, she ain't doing the busted challenge.
No, she better do it like you seen Tamron Hall do the busted challenge.
Oh, wow. Yes, I did.
That's the busted challenge she doing, goddammit.
Not that.
Get busting your damn back. get bust between the damn washer and dryer.
Well, you say bust it to my cell phone and delete it? Oh.
See, so I guess it just this my it, so at the gist of
the
it
hell
is,
you bussing trying to look at the damn camera sexily.
When you see me and I'm posting my look, whatever I'm posting, no matter how sexy, X-rated, whatever you feel like you want to say that it is, know two things: know that I'm a hoochie at heart.
You
marriage
ain't no damn
did
hoochie.
Not change that shit. Know that I would never do anything to disrespect my wife, and she's 110% okay with that. Therefore, in conclusion, and to wrap this shit up, don't DM me and ask me nothing about did Britney let, okay? Because I'm grown, period.
You talk Britney outside, that's why you talking so tough. Cliff.
No, Britney definitely, I think she's actually on the other side of the door in the laundry room.
Yeah, where your ass gonna be at too? Between the damn washer and dryer.
Right.
You're talking big and bad on that podcast earlier.
You think you getting the damn clothes out the damn dryer, she gonna bust you in your damn back. Your hair gonna be stuck between the washer and the dryer, girl. You better stop.
Well, I don't do laundry, so I wouldn't even be getting anything out the washer.
Ooh, you talking? Sorry. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, don't go in there. No, go in there now. You gonna,
I don't. Laundry is Britney's thing.
You're gonna be bump up beside that damn Kenmore.
You are ridiculous.
Hey, nah, she'll be hearing them sounds she heard from the early on them scary movies.
Uh huh.
That
I don't open.
Y'all are ridiculous.
Now, you know, anyway. Courtney got that bread. They got Samsung.
We definitely have Samsung, yep, but I wasn't even going to say nothing.
Yep, I know. Cliff, you got unpopular opinion?
Yeah, bro.
Other than niggas need to stay broke.
Right, because that's what he said.
15. He said, he said it very smart, too. The nigga almost had me. You know, $15 an hour, the effects of the economy and the trickle-down effect and hyperinflation and economy and big word.
It's unpopular, but I'm just saying, well, bro, I'm thinking about the upper level. But anyhow.
It was something specific. Else y'all said three times, too, and I was like, damn, them niggas know that word. It was a phrase that people doing a job because they love it. What's that phrase y'all used?
Intrinsically motivated.
Yes. Intrinsically motivated. I had to throw that in there too. Go ahead anyway.
My unpopular opinion is based on a series of memes that I've been seeing floating around on social media.
All right.
Arby's is not trash, bro. Cool. I don't care what nobody say.
I ate at Arby's the other day.
Dog, Arby's be busting, dog. That turkey, the little mini turkey slider joint.
They buffalo chicken sliders hit too.
The is slamming. The Jamocha shake. I don't even like chocolate shakes, bro.
The apple turnovers. Shake,
ooh, they salted caramel fucking cookies.
Bruh, bro. That motherfucker. Oh, I don't know who.
The cheese sticks, bro.
Y'all niggas making me hungry.
Ooh.
Lord, hey, check this out.
30 minutes for me, but yes.
It ain't Lord. 30 minutes for me. Right down the street.
6 minutes, my dog.
Bruh. They got a y'all listen now, because I know they sell drugs out of Arby's too. They got, because ain't no way Arby's making that much bread to buy. Them niggas bought Bed Buffalo Bath & Beyond Wild or some shit. Oh, that was some weird shit. Yeah, they did buy all the Buffalo Wild Wings. Mm-hmm. But they got a fried turkey sandwich on some kind of soft bun, y'all.
Not some kind
of. Now, I did, last week I had a bad experience at Arby's. Now, I was on the way to record another show. And I hadn't eaten all day. So I was like, let me stop and give me something to eat. You know what I'm saying? I was on 52. Y'all know where that at, 52. Mm-hmm. And I went there, I ordered. I said, let me get number 11. But the girl must be her 7. I wanted a damn bacon chicken sandwich with the cheddar on that bitch. I get my sandwich. I'm down the road. It's a wrap. So I go back. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yeah, I didn't order this all number 11. So she was like, okay. I was like, you want this back? She was like, no. I was like, cool. I can save this wrap for later. Because I eat the wrap, but I just didn't want the wrap right then. She was like, all right, we'll fix it. We'll straighten you up or whatever, whatever. She came back to the window. She was like, yeah, I need that sandwich. Oh, I was like, damn. There go my damn snack for later. But yeah, Arby's do be good though. Y'all tripping.
Arby's definitely be good. They do. I remember when I saw those memes like, who the fuck eating at Arby's? Well, Arby's got enough money to buy Buffalo Wild Wings. Mm-hmm. Bitch, me.
And I'm did.
I'm eating at Arby's. Period.
Somebody had I think it was Rye from the Black Guy with Tips. He was like, have y'all ever seen a line at Arby's? And I can't say that I have. Right. But I do be going there.
I be going, but I ain't never had to wait in no significant line. But
it might be two cars ahead of you at the moment.
That's it. Yeah. Like, yep, that's right. It.
My unpopular.
Arby's before I eat any place else. Bro, like McDonald's or Burger King, dog. Arby's above them all, bro.
Zaxby's?
You know. No.
Above what? Chick-fil-A?
No. It ain't above them. Arby's ain't above them now.
That what he
said? I'll say this for the service, bro, because Chick-fil-A just be so packed always, man.
Man.
But you still be in and out, though.
Yeah, I don't know how they do it, man. Chick-fil-A must be just know.
Magic.
Oh, they know B.E.'s are coming up here now, so let me go ahead and start getting his shit ready. And that's even when you don't order off the app. Because you drive through the line, and you be in and out of there for three minutes.
You do, like, literally, like. Yeah. Chick-fil-A always be on, and I haven't had a bad time. Burger King been having me all up in their drive-thru lately, and I ain't used to fuck with Burger King, but they spicy chicken, I add pickles to that hole, and it's good.
Yeah, I'm always, y'all motherfuckers acting like y'all too good for Burger King. Y'all don't know where y'all come from.
And I love their onion rings.
The onion rings be slapped.
Yep. They slap so hard. But then the other day, this is how you know I be having these big people dreams. I was dreaming about a fish filet. And I was like, I don't want McDonald's fish filet. And I saw Burger King had one. I said,
that shit would be.
And I said, I'm going to try it. Brittany was like, this ain't the day to be trying food because you hungry. No, I mean, let me get that with an onion ring. And I got extra tart on that hoe. No cheese. Oh my God.
It was good.
Y'all, that shit hit so motherfucking hard, bro.
I ain't no fish nigga like that. If I'm gonna eat fish, I'm going to Bay Island. That's my uncle restaurant.
Listen, but where I live, I used to fuck Bay Island up. But ain't no spots like that really around here.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Ain't no spots like that up here. So I gotta do what I can do. I did tell Brittany that I was like, "Fucking, we go grocery shopping. I'm buying me some fish. I'm gonna fry that hoe up at home. I'm tired of wanting some real good ass fried fish and ain't no spots around here. Yeah, ain't none.
Take the good.
Y'all saw Burger King got the tuna sandwich coming out, man.
Yeah, that's in the Bahamas though. That ain't around here.
Oh, I didn't even know that part. But I was
not me either. Yeah, I wasn't rocking with it. I was like, yeah, no, that's dead, bro.
I ain't going there for that.
Simmer down.
But I mean, shit, niggas eat tuna at Subway, and that shit be sitting out all damn day.
Not me.
Niggas be going there. Let me get a tuna. My mom used to get that tuna salad at Subway. I'm like, mom, what? It just sound nasty, all mashed up and shit.
Stomach be all bust up.
I think my mama got that shit because she know I ain't want it. Because anything else, I'm like, let me get a piece. Once you get, kids. You get kids, you got to find out what they don't like.
That's true.
I'm going to get a whole bunch of shit with shrimp in it. Damn, I can't have none of that.
That's what I be trying to do with Brittany. Get some shit she don't like, but she eat everything she likes everything that I like, but she'll get stuff that she know I don't like, and I be pissed.
Because you a half a hoochie, that way. I wouldn't get in there for your half hoochie ass anyway. No, you can't have none of my shrimp tartare or whatever shit. That ain't even a thing.
You wouldn't eat your stuff.
My unpopular opinion ain't as good as y'all's, I don't think. They say that money can't buy happiness. Just use a motherfucking lie. I'm gonna be happy as hell. Let me win this goddamn lottery. I'm gonna be a happy motherfucker, goddamn. Shit. I'm happy with some new cars and I might do some damn real ass old school Dame Dash shit. Just wear drawers one time, wear socks one time, just go places and just shop wasteful. When I get there. Blaze used to talk about y'all probably know the rapper Lil Roof. Some of y'all,
God, I don't know why that keeps playing on my phone.
It's a little button on the side. You push that bitch down. It'll take care of all of that shit, cuz.
But you know, every time I like pick it up, because I'm like, ooh, I let me see, like I got a text, let me pick it up. And every time I pick it up, it's going to automatically unlock because face, and then it just starts playing.
Oh. So you ain't got that shit. Don't turn it off. Nah, shit, we about done, huh?
Well, I'm just trying to restart the damn phone because I don't want that playing every time.
Oh, dang. Oh,
and
okay.
I ain't turned it off in a while.
Oh, I got it. You ain't turning it off for the listeners or me or you or Cliff. You turn it off because you just trying to reset your goddamn phone. Sorry.
Period.
excuse me for thinking it was about me. I should have known. You don't give a damn about busting it open. You don't give a damn about us.
Shut the fuck up.
Courtney on the damn internet looking like Poison Damn Ivy from Batman. You sexy in a damn plant outfit. What the hell is going on here?
Shut up, Brandon.
Courtney, after a while, she gonna be able to talk to them damn vines. They gonna grab you by your damn thoke and choke your ass out. Anyway,
I be talking
y'all,
to them all the time now.
Yeah, money can make you happy, y'all. Don't believe that bullshit. The motherfucker who wrote that shit was broke as hell. Money can't buy happiness.
If you feel like money can't buy happiness, it can damn sure alleviate a lot of motherfucking stress. And that can almost be the same thing because motherfuckers be real stressed out behind financial shit. So I think, we can go and hang that little saying up.
I was in the hospital. Preach. I was in the hospital for like 2 days, but I wasn't worried about paying my bill when I got out that bitch. I was happy. My mama bought me some food from Substation. Ooh, and I wasn't worried about paying for that shit.
I miss Palmetto Subs.
Yeah, Palmetto Subs, yeah. Old school niggas call it Substation.
God damn.
Anyway, yeah, you'll be back down here just to get some fried fish from what was that place you love going to? I said it wasn't that good.
I ain't love going to. I only went there one time.
Oh, I thought you said you and your daddy go there every time you come home.
No, me and my dad went there that one time. I say every time I come home, me and my dad go out to eat at like a different series of places, or at least we try.
Okay.
Yeah, but no, that was only I had only been there that one time.
Damn, it's in my head. That was like one of your main stops before when you come
home.
Hell
no. Yeah. One of my main stops is going to Lake City Ward's Fish Market, and that's on Mary Had a Little Lamb, baby.
Oh, okay. They white.
No.
Yeah, they white.
You know, I don't know. I've never known. I just know Wards be lit.
If they was
I
black on, you would know.
Jumpin' Jays. I go to Jumpin' Jays. I go. I haven't been to Bay. I haven't been anywhere in Darlington the last two times I've been home. But I used to fuck Bay Island up for sure.
Yeah, Unc be. Oh shit, my cousin be listening. I can't talk about my Uncle Fish. That shit be good, man. Good. Check this out, right? So all right, we about to go, y'all. All right, but I'm gonna tell you about my uncle fry his fish a certain way, so my cousin fry the fish a certain way. And we was at a family reunion, and one of our relatives, I don't know who she was, she came into my cousin. Now my cousin, he like 6'7", 2-something, 3-something, big nigga. Now she came up to him, he looking down, he like, baby, y'all frying the fish a little bit too hard. I'm gonna come back around and get another piece later. He's like, okay, you want this piece right here? He's like, all right. So I like, cuz, you gonna fry this fish soft? He's like, man, hell no, I'm about to fry this shit harder. That damn fish is so damn crunchy. Shout out to cuz though. I know he
used to work at Verizon, but I used to get in my car and speed back there so quick.
Oh, yeah. Verizon and Dollar.
Yep, I gotta call in and know my shit by heart.
Them hush puppies, they be so good.
Oh, I woke up this morning wanting some good ass hush puppies so bad I like to cry. Like, where can I need to go home.
Go to cookout.
Ain't no cookout around here.
Oh, that's just a southern thing.
I reckon ain't none up here.
Can y'all leave? Y'all live in New York, and we about to go, y'all. I'm sorry.
You said
can we y'all got a quarantine. Can y'all leave or come back?
If we fly, we'll have to quarantine. But if we drive, we'll be
won't nobody know.
Right?
Yeah, you so fly, you don't try to quarantine. They're gonna be pulling you off the plane like them white people. I'm not a terrorist.
Damn, I want some fucking hush puppies. Oh,
you're welcome.
I can't wait till we get them orders this summer. I'm ready to fucking go, bro.
Word. Anyway, y'all, thank y'all for listening. Thank y'all for joining me. Thank you, BC Bud, for coming back. Let everybody know where they can find you on social media.
All right, so Bud Bros Podcast on IG. My personal joint is Not the Fake Cliff on IG. And the new sports show coming soon, Crux Media. We out here.
Yeah. Courtney, where can they find you on social media?
You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at Peace Love Locks with 2 S's. And if you love plants, you can find me on Instagram at Peace Love Plants, 2 S's. And stay tuned for the podcast featuring just me.
Featuring just her, yeah. She's gonna do her own
Shut
show. She's gonna
be
like, well, you guys, this is my last episode on the show. I don't have time for y'all. I'm just fucking with you, Courtney. You can do whatever
right.
you want to.
I do, but I like having the conversation piece with people.
Wonderful. But I'm just messing with Courtney, y'all. Don't mind me. Anyway, you can find the show on Instagram and Twitter, DJ Blaze Show, and on Facebook, DJ Blaze Radio Show. You can find me on social media, Preacher_BP. Email us djblazeshow@gmail.com or call us up 404-436-2370. Thank y'all for listening, and we'll catch y'all next week. It's your boy Be Easy,
and I'm Courtney.
DC Bud,
and we out.
Peace.
Let those who have ears listen. Whoever you ask, this is the DJ Blaze Show.